wrote for me a long letter about our mission and establishing churches in Brazil, in Bolivia, in Mexico. And also in Black Africa. All these places were places of preaching, not only of teaching. And our Lord Jesus Christ ordered his disciples saying, teach and preach, the two together, to teach the believers and to preach the unbelievers. More than 90% of the members of our churches in Brazil, in Bolivia, even in Mexico, were baptized in our church, natives of other religions, baptized in the church, became members of the church. The problem is that you in America are not working in preaching. And you have no mission, only teaching the believers, but not accepting those from other churches, nor from other religions. What is your working in mission in America, in Canada? I don't know. If you could tell me, I'll be quite glad to hear about your mission work. You are in America, in Canada, are ambassadors of your Coptic church and Coptic belief. Can you establish other churches? I don't know.
علينا سيدنا الشباب new generation start to make clubs in the university. لما كنت when I was in Montreal, they invite me to speak in the university there. Make Coptic club and Canadian came and listen in this lecture. And start to win people through these clubs in the universities. And many of the American churches where there is a university or great school there, they make like that statement. It's going
to speak about mission. I think Ambantonis Marcus sometimes give lectures about mission in our theological seminary in Jersey or in Sydney. لكن in عمل كرازي وسط الشعب مفيش في افريقيا نيافه الام بولس عملوا وسط السود اللي هناك ويتعمدوا وبيبقوا منهم اسوس وخدام دي مش موجود عندكم
في واشنطن كمان سيدي واشنطن شغل حلو قوي في اجتماع بيحضر عدد كبير قوي امريكان بانتظام في حديد الوقت امريكان كنا مره عاملين كانت ليله النيروز عاملين بالليل ليله صلاه وفي اخرها قداس كان نص اللي حاضرين امريكان
لا يمكن اقف قصاد عمل ينمي ملكوت الله
سليم
Alright, I'll tell you something in our experience of preaching. How we established a church in Ethiopia. The Church of Ethiopia was established in the year 329 during the first year of Saint Athanasius of Alexandria. And he sent for Ethiopia the first bishop named Ephraimontios. Ephraimontios means the man of God. We gave Ethiopia the Christian faith, the Orthodox faith, but we left them for their own culture. We left them for their own culture. They still have their Ethiopian language. We didn't change the hymns, nor the music, nor the musical instruments. بنفس الإيمان لكن مش بنفس الكالتشر، واخدين بالكم؟ مش بنفس الطقس، مش بنفس الألحان، مش بنفس الموسيقى. خلاص، المهم عندنا هو الإيمان، وسايبينهم يعملوا كده. احنا عايزين الإيمان، وبنسيب لكل كنيسة الحرية إنها تحتفظ بالكالتشر بتاعها. دي موجود كده، وفي إريتريا عملنا كده برضو، وفي كتير من كنائس أفريقيا الجديدة برضو بالشكل ده، بنسيبهم بحريته. المهم عندنا هو الإيمان. The first point or the essential point is faith, Christian faith and especially Orthodox faith. And then we leave them for their own culture, music, hymns. As far as on, notice that establishing churches in Brazil, in Bolivia, in Mexico is one of our mission work outside Egypt, and also establishing a church in Black Africa.